The following episode is dedicated to our loyal listeners in Gravelly Bottom Road, Langley Heath, Kent.
Well, no need to beat around the bush. This is the STEEZ. I'm Timmy Taco.
And I, for one, all hail our new alien overlords. So who knows what's, by the time this airs, Tim, I don't know what's going to happen.
Okay, who are you?
I'm Jezbot.
Okay, cool.
And you're Timmy Taco, and this is the STEEZ, and welcome.
Are you saying that the aliens are here?
Oh, well, I'm just making predictions.
Are you jumping too early into mysteries and so-so science?
Could
all
be.
All at once?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. It does seem like a mishmash of
science and myths. But we have got that in this episode, so let's get on with it and
yeah, please,
see
let's
what
do
else
something
we say.
Here. Yeah.
By mistake.
Man up.
Man up. Another one. This is another...
Another man up.
Another man up that I've noticed in the city, because I'm driving right through the city in the mornings.
Mm.
And what I've noticed, the blokes are manning up because they're bloody on time. They're in their fluoros. They're getting to work before the allotted time.
Yeah.
They're getting there well before 7.
Yeah. Yeah.
To sign in.
Okay, so they must have been listening to the show, because you told everybody to man up and set your alarm right.
Yep.
Get up. Mm-hmm. Smile on your bloody dial.
Yes.
That's still a thing that people need to face. But what do they need to do now? You're seeing
them
around.
Well, they're there. They're in. They've got everything ready to go. But I'm seeing a scourge of this. It's the electric scooters and your Segways and electric skateboards and electric bloody all this business, right?
Is it the new marbles?
You know what I mean?
The new fad. You know, you got your yo-yos, you got your marbles, you got your Segways.
It's more of
just
a...
saying, you're mentioning a lot of electronic zip-arounds.
This is the problem. This is the problem. I think that you should bloody walk.
Okay.
Or drive. Or power the scooter yourself. Power the
bike yourself. Use your foots.
What's the point? Like, you're not going to get any exercise in the morning.
You're going to get there fast enough.
You're going to get there fast enough.
But no parking.
You've done nothing. You've had your can of V.
Yeah.
You're smoking a dart on your electric scooter. There was
because you got all this time to stand there.
Standing there.
Yeah.
And there was four of these dudes all going to the same site, all on their matching scooters.
Is it?
Dead set.
Do you think the work's starting to provide these scooters? Were they in hard hats already?
No hardies, but they had had all the gear on. But it's, I think they get cheap parking down the ways.
Yep.
And then you jump in your scoot and you scoot up
man
to the work site.
Man up.
Bloody have a walk.
Yeah.
Do you know what I did the other day to man up?
Yeah.
The elevators weren't running.
Sure.
And, you know, there was a backlog of 16 dudes trying to get up because there's only 3 at a time.
You went up the stairs.
I went up the bloody stairs, 15 flights with
shit.
all my gear and the insulation, you know, the floor underlay stuff.
Yeah.
I was like, I got to make money.
You dragged the floor underlay up
that
with
white
you.
White roll thing.
Oh, okay. That's not so bad. That's not so bad.
Foam.
But that's, did you get up to the top and like go,
it was first thing in the
morning.
And
then no way down because the elevators were fucked.
Well, here's the other piece of advice. You got to know that these elevators break down. So the day before when the elevators are working, I load up the apartments with all the shit I'm going to need for the next day.
So you're not relying heavily on the elevators.
Don't rely on other people to get your work done, Tim.
Okay, man up.
That's two bits of advice in there.
Oh, shit. We could have slipped that into. We could have spread that over several weeks.
Man up by exercising. If you're on an exercise vehicle,
yeah,
power it yourself.
Mm.
Or bloody use the God-given feet you've been bloody given.
I was just thinking, imagine if they could create some kind of scooter machine that could climb stairs and you could just sit on it. And it would climb the stairs. But then I thought, that's an elevator.
Community concerns. Correcting the community's concerns of communities.
Yeah, and then correcting them.
Last week's episode, we were talking about our shocking diet situation at the moment during all the shutdown. Yeah, and you had expressed your 2 minute noodle bachelor chow.
Oh yeah. We got into that.
Yep. Yeah, I had Macca's. I haven't been eating. I've been eating one meal a day. Basically, it's like right at the end
of the day.
Dinner.
Yeah, din dins.
Yeah.
So when you combine breakfast, lunch, and dinner into one meal, what's the compressed word for that? Fast dinunch?
What about brina? Does that work? We could work the lunch in there. How about we figure this out for next week?
Sure.
But the bloody guts, I just have not been eating anything. Well, Cassie comes home and anything cooks a good...
Macca's at the end of the day. Well, well that's probably going to do it. You're literally eating poo.
Yeah. But you know, it's a single tube from your mouth straight out.
Oh, I thought you were telling me that Macca's comes in a tube now. You know, it's a single tube.
Well, it could. But
we just invented something then?
Nothing actually absorbs into your body for Macca's. It just goes into the in-hole and straight
through. In the
flute
and out the tube.
Exactly. But it is a concern. You know, Cassie cooks a healthy dinner at the end of the night, but
sure,
I just can't bring myself to cook.
You're just pushing lunch close to dinner. Mm. So you're saying you're having two dinners?
I'm having four coffees and then dinner.
Okay, so you're just skipping breakfast.
Yeah, and lunch.
And swapping lunch for coffee.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
I'm sure my breath is. You're making just it though. Atrocious. I'm making it. The coffees.
The distance.
Oh. Yeah. I've got too much energy. I'm trying to
too much coffee.
Deplete my there you go. Right.
Too much bloody energy. And my breath streaks. And my teeth are
rotten.
Yeah. All right. Shiny hint of gold.
Hey, that's something that's never gonna come back in full force, is the dentist. Because now it's been 3 months and no one's bloody
I always
got a cavity and
I must admit
it's a scam.
With the old dentist and the old gloves. And then the pasty gloves in your mouth.
Yeah.
It does feel like they are wearing gloves from before every time a dentist touches my mouth.
Yeah, I want to see fresh gloves all the time.
Do you ever see the dentist putting them on? Or are they like, oh, Jeremy, you're here.
I think that's something I've noticed.
Or they go like this. And then they go. And reach in your mouth and go, oh, you got some kind of fucking fungus in your mouth. What kind of fungus? Oh, they look like my fingers.
I just never trust. I've got a good dentist, but you just never know. It's like going to a mechanic, isn't it? You just don't know who's scamming you.
So, can we get the community concerned? No, food.
Food
is the concern. Mm. I'd say one, two, skip a few.
Yeah.
99, 100 when it comes to your coffees.
Ah, yeah.
And then
just have one. You think?
Push your lunch. Push your dinner. Forward to about midday, so turn your dinner into a lunch, skip breakfast. And then dinner is when Cass gets back and cooks
get
you up
good
a
nutrients. Yeah.
And some vegetables.
Yeah, that's
a
true.
Fistful of vegetables.
And lashings of ginger beer.
True.
I should really do something about it. Maybe a bowl of something simple, even like a bowl of Cocoa Pops. Just
Cocoa Pops.
At least it's something.
All right. I think we've brought this community concern up many times before. Yeah. Jezbot's not eating. He's still not eating. But look, you're saving room for plenty of drink later on.
Yeah, that's right.
You just guzzle down, fill up the guts.
Yeah.
Now, whenever the coffee gets pissed out, you've got to replace it with some kind of liquid, don't you, Jeremy?
Well, it's a community concern. Won't answer that. Yeah.
All right. Cool.
No, it's not.
Yeah.
It's not at all.
It's actually all right. I forgive you.
You're all doing it.
Can you have dessert before dinner?
I plan to tonight.
Okay, because I'm cooking din-dins and Ness will get home from work and she'll head for the cupboard, get out some Savoys.
Yeah.
She gets a bit of hummus.
Oh.
You know, I have a bit of dippins and I'm like, hey, what are you fucking doing? I'm cooking dinner right now.
You're gonna ruin your appetite.
Yeah, you're gonna ruin your appetite. Then we sit at the dinner table and everyone's like, you know, like shoving peas to one side and miserably forking away at their food. I'm like, what's wrong with everybody? They're like, no one's hungry anymore.
Ah.
Right? So it really gets my goat. There's two things against my gait, Jeremy. It's snacks before dinner. So I would recommend you don't have dessert before dinner is what the point of this is.
Right.
But I also hate a dirty kitchen before I cook. I got to clean the kitchen thoroughly.
Yeah, well,
From tits to toes.
Because you're not an animal.
from soup to nuts. From
snout to tail.
I really have to give it a good scrape out. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. For sure. Well, I'll tell you, last night I had a Cassie brought home from the Baker's Delight. Always slip in something. Or the
always
cookie.
Delightful.
Always slip in something for the ladies. I think the cookie, it's not Baker's Delight. It was a cookie joint.
Okay. Granny Mays.
Yeah, something like that.
Granny Mays? What was the Mrs. Fields.
And you can't.
That bitch.
Not have that before dinner.
Oh,
it was in the bag.
Saying.
She brought it home. I had to have it.
Oh, don't
I had
eat
to have
before
it.
Fucking dinner, man. You're going to
ruin the whole dinner anyway.
You're going to ruin the baklava. That I've planned for after dinner. It's no good. Look.
Tell you what. Tomorrow night, don't cook them anything. Say snacks.
Snacks.
Everyone.
Snacks for dinner.
Yeah.
Oh, could you do snacks for dinner? Because we commonly do.
It's my favorite type of dinner.
We commonly do brinner, which is breakfast dinner. Right? Some brins.
What? Lasagna and wine.
No, that's dinner for breakfast. We do that occasionally too. Lasagna and wine for breakfast. But I'm talking about, like your scrambos.
Yeah, for dinner.
For din-din.
It's the best thing ever.
Why aren't we doing breakfast at dinner?
Too many eggs. Because you're having breakfast as well.
So why did dinner miss out on the egg train?
I don't think it has. I think egg is in everything. Just like the wheat board has got their dirty little...
And big sugar.
Big sugar, big wheat, and big...
Fucking nuts. I gotta go.
I've gotta go have something to eat.
Yeah, I'm hungry.
Can I please leave?
Nope. One more segment.
This is a COVID update. I just want you to...
COVID 1984.
Exactly.
1984.
Yeah, I got it.
Yep.
Disgusting.
I think I got the COVID. I definitely gave you the COVID.
Oh, yeah, because I'm...
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Do you burp on COVID now?
No, this is the problem, man. Cassie storms in on Sunday morning when I took this screenshot of what she...
Get up!
What she showed me.
Right.
It was 9:49 a.m. Sunday morning.
Mm-hmm.
And this is a screenshot off me phone, Apple.
Okay.
Go into your health... you'll do this right now. Have you got your phone?
No, I don't. Give me one second.
Yeah, fair enough.
Okay, I got my phone.
Got phone.
Yes,
right.
I got it.
So, now, go into the health...
I'm in there.
...section of your phone.
Yes.
Now, go to the bit where it says we're tracking you for COVID.
What?
Yeah, so...
Where?
All right. Let me just...
What?
Is it
are
well.
We talking... What, what are you talking about here? I thought you were going to get me to compare our activity.
Nah.
So today, just go to today while you're there, just for the listeners' sake.
Yeah, but what app?
On your health app.
I can't even find it now.
You go to search, and you type in health.
Oh, yeah.
Right? And today, the flights I climbed in floors.
Oh, flights of stairs?
Yeah. I'm pushing 1 floor. Is that an average of like 23 steps?
Yeah.
That's in an upwards direction. It said that I've taken 2,052 steps, which amazes me because all I've done is walk from the chair to the kitchen.
Right.
So I must have taken 2,000 micro steps.
I think it's more the phone's got like a pedometer on it. And because it was going up and down, up and down, up and down so many fucking times today.
Wouldn't have been up and down more. Oh, it says I've walked 1.3 kilometers.
Yeah, well, it was a good sesh, I guess. But hey, man, I'm trying to get my app up, my health app up.
like you were doing today, and it wants me to set up the option.
Today, Jeremy's done 7 floors. You've walked a distance of 4 kilometers.
Why are they tracking that? Kilometers. I didn't say they could track that.
Well, you didn't turn it off. And you've done 6,663.
Oh, that's right.
Steps. 6,663 steps.
And I was on my knees half the day. And I've just exposed my knees to Tim.
Yuck. Put them away. Why are your legs so blue? It's like they've never been out before. Have you ever taken those legs out? Apart from in the bath when you're watching Netflix? You're gross. Keep going. Health.
I wanted to
Does
see what
health
else.
Health app say anything about your legs?
No, well, Cass said you've got to go to something on it. God damn it. Ruin the segment. It says this. Like, read that. See if
it
you can see that.
It says COVID-19 exposure logging. It's in the off position, so I think you're right. When enabled, iPhone can exchange random IDs with other devices using Bluetooth. Fuck off. This enables an app to notify you if you may have been exposed to COVID-1984. Expose logging cannot access any data in any data to the health app.
Okay.
So if I turn that on...
That's a photo of...
That's a screenshot. Screeno.
So there's something on there tracking us without your tracking. Yes,
without your bloody... When was the last time you updated? You must have updated during COVID.
I must have.
You must have.
I never update this phone.
Well, you
I'll say I'll go out of my way to get the older phones and not update.
You do sport an old phone, don't you?
It's Dad's old phone.
Oh,
he goes, this phone's fucked.
Yeah.
He's 70.
I'll have it.
I'll have it.
Yeah. Okay. All right, so I guess get onto your phone, check your health app, and see if you've been tracked
for COVID.
For COVID, which some people would go, oh, that's a convenience, that's good. I've got nothing to hide, unless you got COVID. Basically, and then we're all going to fucking hide it.
Yeah, but I just want to buy into it. I want to be.
You want to buy into COVID?
No, do you know what it is? It's like when we woke up and we all had bloody U2s. Freaking album on out.
Oh, yeah. That's the real virus.
No choice.
Society.
No choice.
Everyone caught it.
Yeah, that's right. You too?
Yeah. What is it? Hello, hello. Isn't that a U2 song?
Yes.
What's another U2 song, Vanessa? You used to love that shit.
Shit of LA. Can you no name?
Right. What's another one?
Where the streets have no name.
Give me a fucking title.
Lemon
Zeroper.
The ropiest ropes across your chest.
That's a true virus. No, really. And like, you know what? Just like COVID, you can get it again and again and again. Because when you delete that, it magically reappears on your phone.
The album does.
Mm.
Jesus Christ.
Mm, it's like some kind of fucking...
Who did they have to... What devil's cock did they have to suck to get on the fucking everyone's phone?
Yeah, the eye cock. They sucked the eye cock.
Eye cock. Eye cock myself all day.
To you too.
Yeah.
You too. And also with you.
And also with you. Well, I did 6 flight of stairs, so you know what I've been up to.
Oh, fucking hell. You're all right.
Man, on it.
Shit. All right, check your health app.
I was in bed the other night and
amazing.
thinking about times gone by, you know, because we're not allowed to travel anymore. And I thought, geez, I remember all the times, the dodgy night sleeps I've had overseas
you
and stuff. Yeah.
I hate Booty. I want to go home.
And I was so glad to be in my nice new mattress. And and there was no one in the hostel with me.
Yep.
And I remembered a time I went to Turkey, and I was my traveling partner and I.
Oh, sorry, Sean would want me to go.
Sure. I'd heard, this is before the internet really kicked in, you don't have it on your phone. So there's no travel pages and whatever.
There's no recommendash.
No recommendashes apart from your uncles or friends that have been over.
You're really saying you really must go.
You really must go to the tree houses in Turkey.
Sure.
It's awesome. It's like, you know, for young people and stuff. So like you did that, didn't you? Yeah, it was like, well, that's what I said to Amber. It's like, well, why don't we go down to Turkey? I heard it's... This is
true, as my uncle said.
My uncle said. Fucking so, like...
My uncle Ned.
I think we might have made it to... We found the address, obviously, but it was a good 16-hour bus ride.
16 hours?
It's bus rides everywhere, dude, because we were at Gallipoli, and then we're like, oh, and then what are we going to do
Did you
now?
Call it Gallipoli?
I think I might have said Gallipoli. It's Gallipoli, I'm pretty sure. But, too soon, those poor bastards.
Lest we forget. Bloody hell.
Yeah, so we get down there, and by the time we arrive...
There's 1,000 people there?
It's 4 o'clock in the morning, and there's no one around.
Oh.
And we...
are tired.
Oh, well, dude, it was... After the bus ride, it was a taxi. The taxi guy kind of... this handing him a scrap piece of paper, and he's like, I think I know where this is. Let's head out there. And then he's stopping every hour... They go, where am I? You know where this is? Dudes with ice cream stalls and stuff.
When you say taxi, is he? Are you on the clock there? Ding, ding, ding. And he's like just driving into the Turkey wilderness looking for tree houses.
It was crazy. Like, I don't even know how we found that guy. I think we might have had to stay up all night because we got dropped off the bus at midnight. Anyway, it was a crazy story.
It's a nightmare.
Yeah, it was a nightmare. It was 2001. So,
yeah, right.
Memories are... bit.
Oh, it's a bloody different world then. Different world.
It was. It was pre-9/11, which is why I came home, because that happened while I was over there.
Sure.
Anyway, we get to Turkey. We wake up the dude. He gives us a room.
Yeah.
We get up in the treehouse. We're like, oh, finally. I was like, couldn't really see what was going on at the resort, if you'd like to say.
He said he did the old... quotation marks.
Yeah. And then finally put our shit down, put our heads down on the pillows, and we're just drifting off. And I hear from the bunk below, are you itchy?
Oh. And I'm like, was that somebody else?
Yeah, yeah, my traveling partner. Okay. We were just,
get up. Are you sleeping on top of me?
Oh. So separate beds. Just traveling partners. And then I start like feeling a little bit weird as well. And it's like, drift off. And then 5 seconds later, and like brushing something off my skin.
Okay.
And so we turn the lights on and we are like sleeping in this tree house of hot bed bugs.
Oh.
Bed bugs everywhere. Like, maybe not even bed bugs, but they were dropping from the tree house roof.
Oh.
And we're like, where the fuck are we? What is this fucking joint?
So you didn't think to turn on the lights when you first went in there?
Well, we turned the lights on.
Oh, for the sake of the story. Yeah, sure.
Anyway, so like... the next
Bed bugs. Don't let the bed bugs bite. Because they go. They'll definitely bite.
Rapidly.
Don't let them, but they'll do it anyway.
So about 3 hours, I guess we get 3 hours off and on sleep. The roosters start.
Oh, right.
So it's one of these places.
Oh.
And by the time the piercing hot Turkish sun comes up, it's hitting that treehouse. We're like, what the fuck? It's like a sauna.
Oh.
And then I've dragged her all the way down there. I was like, this is going to be sick. And we like stayed for another night.
More bed bugs?
Well, we complained, obviously, and got another tree house, but it was like a tree house like you and I would build when we were 16.
Right.
So, all right, we're going to start this resort because we've got these massive pine trees
in Matt's backyard, in the tree,
and put beds and a light and a ladder.
What more do you need?
Yeah, a toilet.
Oh, yeah, nah, you just
a fan.
Ooh, no fans.
It was crook.
16 hours.
So back on the bus. We were like, we got to get the fuck out of here.
Yep. All the way home?
I went back to Amsterdam. She went to London.
Oh, she left. Yeah, she bailed. Yeah. Hey, catch us later.
Yeah, pretty much.
And she walks off into the distance, scratching.
Well, she went to meet up with her then new boyfriend, Jeremy.
Yeah.
Which is my name. Who had long hair and was the youngest of five boys.
Why wouldn't she go for a guy like you? I've got everything if your guy's got.
Because I'm the type of guy that will take someone down to the pits of Turkey and...
Yeah, and get them bitten by bugs all night. Interesting
story.
I don't know how you got through that, because...
I don't know.
I'm not big on the old crawly things in the bed sitch.
And you're not big on 16-hour bus rides. You're not big on long plane rides. You don't like the ocean sand.
I don't know if you're find me in Turkey anytime
large
soon.
Large crowds as well. You don't seem to like a lot.
You know.
Getting to know people's a bit of a...
Yeah. Okay. All right.
Hostel of Horror. Maybe I've got some other ones, but okay. Maybe we'll get into that.
Sure.
I was at the shops.
Sure.
Just getting some
supplies.
Potato cakes and dim sims with chicken salt on it.
Dim sims with chicken salt on it? Yeah. PCs?
Same bag.
Okay.
There's a bit of rub off. Whatever. I don't care. Usually I get tomato sauce on the dimmies, so...
Huh, is it?
Yeah, fuck yeah.
Okay.
I said it.
It's so fucking Aussie, mate.
Anyway, so getting into my car, and the car next to me is a guy who's on his phone, so because I was going to take a photo.
So you're like,
he was parked. It was fine.
Okay, all right. Okay, you're right.
Started sussing out his car.
Mm-hmm.
He's got a dartboard on the back windowsill, right? Laying down.
Dartboard?
Yeah. So laying he's obviously, down. Yeah, that's permanently fixed.
He's a darto.
Right? Yeah, all right, fair enough. But the dude's like, it's like one of those old, I think it was an old Jag, but one of those fucking
drug
pieces of shit, like just clapped out. It's he bought it secondhand.
It's probably a Wags Jag.
Yeah, it's no good anymore.
Okay, sure.
And so then next to that, he's got like, in the back seat, he's got his teddy bear. Buckled in to the middle seat.
Sorry, I said that so fucking loud. Sorry. Buckled in.
And then
what kind of teddy bear, Jeremy?
Like a Winston teddy bear,
like a Paddy Paddles. What's his
name?
Paddington bear.
And
strapped in,
so it's permanent.
Safe, Billy.
Permanently fixed. And then I was trying to take photos of him because I knew he was just going to turn around at any stage. Now, in his cigarette...
Did you get a photo?
In his cigarette ashtray.
Wait, how fucking close are you to this dude?
Right next to it.
Okay.
Right next to the car.
How can you see in his ashtray?
Because I'm looking at it.
You did take photos.
Yeah. He's got his little farm set up. So he's got a little piglet. He's got a little lambikin. And he's got a little cowie wowie.
He's got his little horsey. Yeah.
So he's got his whole...
He's got the whole farm in there.
He's got his whole car set up like, you know, when you're 18, you first get your cow.
Yep.
I even had like a little cactus on my fucking dashboard.
Oh, sure, man. Every one
like,
of my cars, I've got a little... Stormtrooper.
Yeah, of course. Yeah, but just one.
Can I have a look at Squidgeridoo that day?
Because we talked about this before. Like,
these people, they do go all out with their fucking
toys. You can't even see out the back window.
No, but what's with the dartboard?
There's no photo of it because I was trying to get the photo, but I knew at any second.
If he's trying to tell the girls around town that he's a darto.
Yeah, I guess like Saturday nights with me, love. You're gonna first we're gonna take Winston for a bath and put him to bed. Then we're gonna get a babysitter, and then we're going
Feed
off to darts.
Fucking hell!
What a night out. Although at this fucking time, this point of time,
It's good. Isn't it?
I would love to fucking go out and play darts somewhere.
I would go. I would become a darto if it meant. Just bloody hanging with me, bloody.
I have to get plenty of gloves, though.
Yeah?
Can't share darts. Starboard's got it.
We're going to lose darts. We're going to lose it.
Or it's going to be a renaissance of dardos because, you know, I got a dartboard for Chrissy, you know?
Yeah.
Chrissy. People have been buying dartboards. When I went into Revel Sports, there was no bloody dartboards left. It's a good cheap present, man.
Yeah.
But maybe there's going to be kids coming up and they're going to have like super, who's that guy at the Marvel movies?
Marvel movies?
Yeah, Dardo. The Dardo. It's Arrow guy. Arrow.
Yeah.
Arrow. Arrow.
Dardo. Arrow man.
Yes. Maybe we're going to get a whole bunch of kids like fucking getting into darts, man.
And then they'll come down and they'll be like, we need your best sharpshooters ever. Hey.
Just so happens.
Bobby's pretty good on the old dardos.
It's going to come down to a dart off between the Chinese and the Australians to avoid war. We're not going up against them in ping pong, man.
Hey, just because you brought up the Chinese, did you say Chinese?
I did.
The question I was just perusing questions on the internet.
Oh yeah,
somebody asked the question. Is this a dumb question? First, if you have to ask that, yes, it is.
And you are a dumb person.
I'm just about to ask, am I from Hong Kong or am I Chinese?
Well...
Is Hong Kong a country? No.
No, they've got independence from... Oh. Remember they took that? That's why all those the protests that were going on last year before...
At Hong Kong.
And those guys weren't giving up for nothing.
Right.
Even anything.
Okay.
And that's all over now.
Okay.
They stopped that riot, that 9-month riot that was going on.
So was the honker, honkers dozen conkers.
Well, the Chinese army was getting really close, Dan was telling us. Like, they were on the borders of like, ready to roll in. And I guess the tear gas wasn't working. I guess the rubber bullets and... the arrests weren't working, so I mean, I'm not saying they did it for this reason, but
they certainly did do it for that reason.
Well, it just helps out, it worked out in the end, didn't it?
In the end.
They don't want us protesting, I'll tell you that much.
Anyway, I think we covered that.
Hello, everybody, this is Timmy Tucker reporting for. Escape Pods, and we are currently in Thailand. You really must go. And I'm here with Mason.
Hi.
And we're looking for something cool to buy. And Mason was just saying to me that he wants to buy a gun. A gun. And I was saying it's a bit hard to get into the country. So what did you say?
Get something better than a gun.
Oh yeah, we could do that. You said. Can't we just hide it?
Yeah.
Yeah, you did say that, didn't you? But, like, we're going to keep looking around. Hopefully we can find you a hand pistol, machine gun, shotgun, or something that you can ship it with. Yeah.
But it has to have something, like, soft.
Oh, you like a Nerf gun?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you wanted a real gun. Oh, that's my mistake. All right, cool. All right, signing out. See ya.
See ya.
Oh, well done, Timmy Taco. They're recording live from Thailand. You really must go.
You really must.
Yeah, so it's fear of the week again.
Is it?
Yeah, because there's so much fear going around.
So many weeks.
What are you fearful of?
I'm not having enough podcast content.
Yeah.
Out with it. Is that it?
No, I was going to say I'm fearful of them never shutting the fuck up or see.
Oh, yeah?
No, now I'm doing it.
Now you are doing it.
Cut me off.
Cut you off?
Yeah.
Okay. Wow, you're scaring me, man. Scared of Jezbot of the week.
Oh, rightio. Pack it up, boys.
Pack it up, boys.
Yes. Tools down, everyone.
Tools down. The best part of the day.
I thought I was listening to the STEEZ with Jezbot and Timmy Taco. Yes, thanks for listening.
Sure. Yeah, thank you very much. Tune in each and every week. We will never end. We'll never stop. So don't sleep on it. Don't rest.
just like the unions, we're going to fight for your bloody right to listen to us talk.
Yep, right, pals. I'm going to listen to the regular podcast, but don't stop listening to the STEEZ each and every week. It's Timmy Taco and Jezbot.
And make sure you paid up your membership fees, boys, because they're due this week.
You can stop graffiti the toilets.